Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss something about hierarchy. So let's get started. So first we are going to discuss about what is hierarchy. So from this pictures, you can easily understand about the hierarchical organization. Talking about something about the hierarchy, it describes a system that organizes or ranks things, often according to the power or the importance. Also known as pecking order or power structure. Also, it is an important concept which is used in wide variety of fields like organization theory, system theory, mathematics, social science, and even in the hotel industry. And even every department in our hotel, from front office to food production, from KST to accounts, every department follows hierarchy system. A hierarchy is a formalized or simply implied understanding of who's on top or what's more important. So coming to the next point, in food production department, the rank order plays a very important role, as this is the way from which we can say that who reports to whom and who has what duties and responsibilities. Hierarchy is important as it helps in understanding the position of different chefs at different levels. Also, having a strong hierarchy system shows the success of the organization. Coming to the next slide. In this slide, we're going to discuss the major hierarchy, which is followed in the kitchen. In the next upcoming video, I'm going to discuss about the duties and responsibilities of the different chefs. Then your concept will become more clear about the organization structure. The first one is the executive chef. He is the highest ordered chef in the whole kitchen brigade. He directly reports to the general manager of the hotel and is in charge of every doing inside the kitchen. He is one of the chefs who takes briefing and checks that everything in the kitchen is going in the right place. Then there comes the executive sous chef. He also almost have the same powers as the executive chef and the sous chef. His major duties is to take charge of the kitchen at the place when the executive chef is not present. Then the third one comes as sous chef. He is the one who looks into every department specifically, that each department of the kitchen is working properly. To see the different sections of the kitchen, do check out our video on the channel. In that video, you're gonna have the greater knowledge about the different sections of the kitchen. He also approves indenting of each section of the kitchen. If I speak something about indenting, so every section needs ingredients on a regular interval of time. So the chef de partie, the CDP, the next coming chef, which are the head chef of the section, makes an indent of the ingredients which they require for the preparation of the dishes. That indent is approved by the sous chef, and then the CDP will collect all those ingredients from the store. There are different many other duties and responsibilities of the sous chef. Coming next to the CDP, that is chef de partie. He is the head chef of the section of the kitchen, like continental section, Indian section, etc. He also checks that all the orders from his or her section will go on time and with the proper standards. So up till now, till the sous chef, all the chefs are taking the responsibility, they're taking the care of the whole kitchen. But from the CDP, the chef de partie, the chef de partie, and under these chefs, these are all those chefs which are taking care, which are responsible for the particular sections only. So the next coming up are commis. So the first one is commis 3, then is commis 2, and then there is commis 1. So all these commis have majorly the same duties, as in many of the establishment there are single post for the commis, not like commis 3, 2 and 1. They majorly prepare all the dishes according to the order as per the standards. They also do the mise en place, that is pre-preparation. So mise en place is known as pre-preparation. All the pre-preparation of the dishes which are done for the dishes at the time they are prepared. So all these pre-preparation are also done by these commis itself. Finally, in the end, there are apprentice and trainee. These are those people who lie in the bottom of the kitchen hierarchy. These people are those who people came to learn here about the kitchen, about the ingredients, the dishes, and how the kitchen works. So these are those people who want to grow up in the industry, want to grow up in the kitchen. So they are going, they are came here to learn, to gain some experience from the kitchen. So then in the next slide, in this slide, we are going to discuss about the French hierarchy, which is the first given by Chef George Auguste Escoffer. I had also made a video on Chef George Auguste Escoffer on my channel. You can check that out. In this slide, a detailed hierarchy of kitchen is given. All the French names are written in small box also. As we had discussed earlier, firstly, there is executive chef, whose French name is Chef de Cuisine. Then there is sous chef. Then comes the head chef all of different sections. So basically, there are different sections written in detailed form, and all the French names are also written there. First is the sauce cook, Le Chef Saucier, a chef who prepares different types of sauces. Roast cook, Le Chef Rotisserie, who prepares all the roast items like roast chicken, roast duck. One more thing I want to tell you, that this brigade is seen in usually a large hotel property which have a very large kitchen. So as different sections do their different work specifically. Then there is fish cook, that is Le Poissonnier, a chef which deals with the fish preparations. The next is grill cook, who cooks all the grill dishes in the kitchen. Vegetable cook, Le Entremetteur, a chef who cooks vegetables for meat dishes as well as for the vegetarian dish preparations. Then there is a soup cook, Le Potage, who is responsible for preparing different types of soups. After soup cook, there is larder cook, Le Chef de Garde-Manger. He is the one who takes care of the cold kitchen orders. All the cold items are prepared here. Under him, there are three chefs. The first one is cold work cook, Le Chef de Froid, a chef who takes care of all the cold work, whether it be the decorative, cold items or the cold dishes. Another one is adorf cook. So it's, as you can see the word, it's not pronounced as the English word, as these are the French words. So these are pronounced, it is pronounced as adorf, adorf, not horse the ovio. It is pronounced as adorf. So another one is the adorf cook, Le Chef de Froid. Its French name is also Le Chef de Froid, who is in charge of preparing all the appetizers. So to know more about appetizers, I've also uploaded a video on appetizer. You can check that out on our channel. Finally, there is butcherie, who takes care of the all the meat items. Then there comes pastry cook, Le Pâtissier, bakery, Le Boulanger, and ice cream cook, Le Glacier. All these cook works in bakery with this special products and their special equipments with their proper workspace. These cooks work together in the bakery and give out their orders. Then comes the Indian section cook. Under him, there is Tandoor Chef. Under him, there is Tandoor Chef who prepare all the tandoori dish. To know more about the tandoori dishes, I had uploaded a video on my channel. You can go and check that out. And then there is a halwai, a chef who prepares the Indian dessert. After that, you can see that there is Indian hot section cook, who is responsible for preparing all the curries, gravies, rice, etc. Then comes, there is a relief cook, Le Chef Torrent. He takes over a section which its chef goes on a leave. So basically, when a chef goes on a leave or has an off day, this is the chef who takes place on its section. This chef is usually a senior chef and is capable of commis, as he has the knowledge of various sections. So he is the one who take care of different sections in the kitchen, as if the major chef, if the commis or if the chef de partie of the section has a leave or has a day off. Then the breakfast cook, Lee Chef de Petit de Juno. He commences his duties very early, responsible for the complete breakfast service. After, he has to complete his mise en place for the following morning. So breakfast cook has the duties of the breakfast orders, and finally he also has to complete the mise en place, the pre-preparation for the following coming morning orders. So that's all about the hierarchy I'm speaking. So that's all for the day, guys. I hope that this video will help to increase your knowledge. Make sure you hit the like button, comment down if you still have any doubts, share it with all your friends, and for more such knowledge, keep watching What the Food. Bye bye.